Happy New Year.
Hey, Happy New Year, Whitewater.
We're so glad that you're meeting in your homes today. We're actually in Michael's home.
Hey, Michael. Yep. And we hope you're having pancake church or waffle church, or hopefully not cold and no heat church in your home. But we really wanted to take a time to rest this week and build relationships. So I hope you're with family, friends, roommates. We just want to encourage you to take a time of reflection and rejoicing. We see that as a really, really important practice in the New Testament. There's Paul, who wrote a third of the New Testament. He said this in Philippians chapter 4. He says, "Fix your thoughts on what is true, honorable, right, pure, lovely, admirable. Think about these things that are excellent and worthy of praise." I just think that's incredible to take time to reflect. And he goes on to say, or he actually said earlier in the passage, "Always be full of joy in the Lord. I say again, rejoice." So reflecting on the blessings and even the brokenness of our lives is so important so that we can rejoice in how God is redeeming those things or how he's using those things in our life. And so I want to encourage us right now maybe to take this opportunity as a springboard to reflect and rejoice with your spiritual family. As we've looked back at this last year and reflect on it, what are some of the things that we would rejoice and celebrate?
Yeah. I think a lot of our rejoicing has to do with our spiritual family. But if I look at our kind of immediate family, for those of you that don't know, I went through a good long 5 years of chronic pain. And I feel like in a lot of ways, I'm still coming out of that. I think healing takes time. And a lot of my conversations this year kind of revolve around just coming back to myself. I feel like for a good 5 years, I wasn't myself. And I think I put a lot of numbness and kind of just as a way to protect myself. And in a lot of ways, I feel that numbness melting, or that shell, that kind of that protective shell, starting to soften again, which I really appreciate. And I think just watching my kids has really brought that out. Wes is truly a miracle, and we're so thankful for him. And I'm looking back at seasons of pain. I can see how God does use those seasons to help me grow. And even in Novella's life, our six-year-old daughter, I don't think she'd have a depth and an emotional intelligence that she does if we didn't go through those things. And I wouldn't have said that going through the pain process. But yeah, I want that for you know. But I think even looking back at hard times, we can rejoice in what that is. And even if it doesn't feel like it's going to end, I think God gives us hope in those moments.
Yeah, for me personally, it's just been a year of rejoicing with my kids. It's been an amazing season as a father and as a husband. And my daughter is having an awesome year in first grade. And every other Monday, I go in and I read from the Chronicles of Narnia to her classroom. And my dad, he goes on the other Mondays. We get to share that experience to kind of be in the classroom and see her and her friend group. And that's been really special. And then I would agree with Sarah, like our little boy Wes is 2 years old and he's just a miracle baby. Doctors told us we probably weren't going to have another little one. And he's just been such a joy. And he's exerting his will right now. And every time he does it, I tell myself, this is the sign of a miracle that God has given us a little boy who has a will to exert. And so that's been really cool. So Sarah, when we think about our spiritual family, our church at Whitewater, what are a few things that we would reflect on and rejoice in?
I think it's so fun to be in a new building. There's excitement. There's so many new faces. It's fun to have a growing spiritual family. And I also look back at the old memories at the station house. And as we were packing up, people's talking about, you know, I remember I walked down this hallway with my bare feet after I got baptized. Or I remember the journey track and the friends I made in that class. It's just fun to see how our family, our spiritual family, is growing and the memories that we make no matter what building we're in.
I mean, our church, we believe we're blessed to be a blessing, and God has blessed us, and our church is being a blessing in the community. This is a year of a lot of cool firsts. We have our first partnership globally with churches in Sierra Leone. God is doing some incredible work there. Stay tuned for more on that this year. We launched our first financial campaign for a building, permanent building to call home, and so we're building a nest egg to purchase property or a building. And man, we're just so excited. Thank you for your generosity in that area. And like Sarah said, if you hadn't noticed, we're in a new building, and I'm so excited about that relationship at Step by Step and what and how God has used that and how he will use that. Two things I think we'd like to kind of close on. One is, if people were to look back on their year, what would you encourage them to do?
Yeah, I think just looking back, just what is God saying to you through your last year? And I would encourage you to even go to the harder spots. I know for me, I don't really want to go there, but that's really where God meets us. And I think he softens our hearts if we're willing to open it up. And so I'd really encourage you to look at those, even those painful spots or the parts that you don't really like talking about. Find safe people or journal or do something to look back. What's God saying to me? And then what am I going to do about it? So not just thinking, what is he doing, but following through with that action, because that's how we grow.
Yeah. And the other thing I would encourage you to do as a spiritual exercise is, after reflecting on the last year and rejoicing in that and really looking at that and asking what God is saying to you, now take a time to look forward and reflect on what God could do in 2020. I know I have dreams for our family, and me and Sarah have dreams together that we're excited about. I know our daughter has dreams that she's telling us about this next year, and we're excited to think about that and reflect on that. And then for our church, for your faith and for your spiritual family, be asking the question, what is God saying to you about 2020? I think for the life of our church, I think this could be one of the most impactful, most amazing years we've ever seen. And I truly believe that the best is yet to come. Mm-hmm. So I want to encourage you to think about the future and be praying and asking God, what are you saying to me about this next year? And I want to invite you, lastly, I want to invite you on January 5th to our new series. We're going to be kicking off our series called Won't You Be My Neighbor? And it's about growing in health in our relationships. And I don't know about you, but I think in every relationship I have, I can always stand to grow more healthy. And so we're going to be looking at a way that Jesus teaches us to heal and become healthy in our relationships. So come back for that. And we're going to be having 4-week series. And what would it look like to commit to 4 weeks for the health of relationships in your life? I think it would be totally worth it. So come back for that. Get ready, Whitewater. It's going to be an awesome year. We want to wish you a happy new year. Hope you had an awesome and very Merry Christmas. We love you guys so much.
Thank you for being our family.
Yeah, we love you.